ends. Now we have to understand the third relation. Okay, relation number third is relation between linear acceleration, that means a, and angular acceleration, that means alpha. इन दोनों के बीच का रिलेशन एस्टेब्लिश करना है. ठीक है, हाउ टू स्टार्ट विथ, वी हैव टू टेक द हेल्प ऑफ वेलोसिटी रिलेशन विच वी डिराइव्ड इन द लास्ट. ओके, सो वेलोसिटी रिलेशन व्हाट वाज देयर, वी इक्वल टू ओमेगा क्रॉस आर. वी विल स्टार्ट विथ दिस. नाउ वी नीड हियर सम फॉर्मूलाज, लेट अस राइट इट एट साइड. रिलेशंस आर दीज विच वी मे रिक्वायर. डीवी बाय डीटी वी कॉल ए, because this is also linear, this is also linear. d omega by dt we can call alpha, because this is angular velocity, this is angular acceleration, and somewhere we may require this relation also. This linear displacement upon time is linear velocity. Okay, let us start now. We have v relation and we have to achieve a, so take the help of first relation. We need to do dv by dt. Okay, differentiation. So let us do differentiation both the sides. So if we do differentiation with respect to time, it will become dv by dt, and here it will become d by dt of omega into r. Okay, now here it is the product differentiation, product of two. Okay, so there is a formula I am writing at side. Formula, whenever the product is given, like u into v, and we have to do its differentiation d by dt. So how to do product differentiation? It is this way: first constant differentiation of second plus second constant differentiation of first. You can see u is constant, dv by dt, plus v is constant, du by dt. Okay, so these u and v are any terms in form of product. So here what we have, we are given omega cross r product, and we have to do its differentiation. So we will apply this formula. I'll speak the formula. What is that? First constant into differentiation of second plus second constant into differentiation of first. Okay, you can see, you can notice that omega always I have kept at the first place only, because it is cross product. And in cross product, no, the position of the vector is very important. We cannot change the position. So omega should always be written at the first location only. Okay. So first constant means omega constant into differentiation means dr by dt of second. Plus second constant means without differentiation, into differentiation of first. Clear? Now let us replace them. Replacing means, what can we write in short for these terms? Like dr by dt is v. So this term is omega cross v. Now this side term, d omega by dt is alpha and cross r. So you have seen here that what we were solving a, that means dv by dt. So a answer has come the summation of two terms, this term and this term. Now we need to understand a little detail about these two terms, omega cross v and alpha cross r. Now we need to understand what does these two terms mean, or what are their directions, or what are these accelerations. Okay, this is first acceleration a1, this is second acceleration a2. Let us name them. So a is a1 plus a2. Now a1 I have given name to omega cross v. So with the help of these diagrams, we are going to understand the directions. We will apply right hand thumb rule. Let us start. First of all, suppose this is a circle which is anti-clockwise. That means the object is moving in a circle anti-clockwise. So we already know d theta vector is normally upward vector. Fine? Okay. Now d theta vector, with the help of this, we will find omega vector direction. Okay. So we have one relation. This relation omega equal to d theta by dt, that means whatever is the direction of d theta, same is the direction of omega. Okay, so if d theta is upward, omega is also upward. I will show in the second diagram. Okay, now omega is velocity, So object is moving here on the circumference. So omega velocity will not be shown at the center. Omega velocity will be shown at the circumference somewhere. So I think you understood why omega is upward, because d theta is upward. They have the same direction. After that, other than omega, we need to draw v velocity. Okay, linear velocity. Now for any circle, the velocity is always the tangent to the circle. Remember this point. So suppose the object is here, we have drawn the tangent like this. Okay, tangent means it's just going this way. On this circle, the tangent is shown. Okay, suppose I draw a big circle, a front view of the circle. So the tangent are this way drawn. Okay, so this is about the linear velocity case. So suppose we are discussing at this point. So here we have drawn a tangent. Okay, now omega cross v direction we can find with the right hand. See, it is the cross product. Omega and v ka cross product hai. Iski direction nikalni ho to right hand thumb rule se nikalenge. Right hand thumb rule says that we have to curl our fingers from omega to v. Okay, so you see omega is upward and v is tangent to the circle. Omega is upward, v is tangent to the circle. What you need to do? You have to stretch your fingers of right hand from omega to v. So you have stretched. So where is the thumb pointing? So thumb is pointing towards the center. Okay, so this direction is the direction of omega cross v. So this acceleration, that means omega cross v part acceleration, is towards the center. That's why we can now call it AC. Its direction is towards the center. Clear? Okay. So what we did? Omega to V. You can also take a resistor or some circle and try. Just understand with the help of this thing. Suppose this resistor is a circle. We are seeing the side view. Here omega is shown upward. And this is the velocity along the tangent. So this is omega, this is v. Now from omega to v, you have to turn your right hand fingers. So this is omega to v. Okay, omega to v, you have to curl your fingers. So where is the thumb pointing? Thumb is pointing towards the center of the circle. This way we have found the direction of omega cross v. Now let us make one more diagram for alpha cross r. So third diagram we need here. Now alpha direction. Alpha formula is here. D omega by dt. That means whatever is the direction of omega, same is the direction of alpha. So alpha is also upwards. Okay, this is alpha. Then we need r vector. Okay, r vector is here. But we have to draw out of the circle. Okay. So this r vector we have picked and kept here. Okay, this is requirement. Now, how is this alpha and r? Let us see on this resistor. Alpha is upward and r is outward like this. Alpha and r. Okay, now from this alpha to this r, we have to curl our right hand fingers. So see, this is the right hand. Curl the fingers from alpha to r. So where is the thumb pointing? Thumb is pointing in this line. That means along the tangent. So alpha cross r direction is this. Okay, I'm just repeating. This is alpha. This is circle. Suppose this resistor is a circle. So this is alpha, this is r. Now curl your fingers from alpha to r. So take right hand. Your alpha is here, alpha to r, curl your fingers. So where is the thumb pointing? Thumb is pointing along the tangent. This is the thumb direction. So this is the tangent drawn. Okay, so this way these are two types of accelerations coming. So this along the tangent acceleration we call at. Okay, so finally we have got this relation, a equal to omega cross v and alpha cross r. So two accelerations are contributing a. Now we will understand one special case in which one of the acceleration will be vanished. that is uniform circular motion. So note down this case. Diagrams, these diagrams are very important. Now we will understand one special case about circular motion. That special case is uniform circular motion. Okay, in which we will introduce the acceleration name centripetal acceleration. Okay, so let us understand. If the object moves in uniform circular motion, then the net acceleration which is towards the center is called centripetal acceleration. Okay, so we will take the help of this general formula of acceleration. Ye acceleration ka formula kiske liye hai? Har circular motion ke liye, for every circular motion. Okay, now in this we will apply the case uniform. Okay, if the motion is uniform, what does it mean? What will cancel in this formula? Let us check. Uniform means the speed of the motion is constant. Speed means omega. It is constant. Now this says that alpha will become 0. Why it will become 0? Because alpha is d omega by dt. But omega just now is constant. And constant's differentiation is always 0. Remember this point or write it somewhere. That constant's differentiation is always 0. That's why alpha is becoming 0 for uniform circular motion. So out of these two quantities, this quantity is becoming 0. So total acceleration of the object is only omega cross v. Okay, and we have seen its direction in the last diagrams. Omega cross v direction is always towards the center. And in Greek letters or Greek words, towards the center is known as centripetal. Towards the center means centripetal. Okay, so omega cross v is called the centripetal acceleration. Now we can make its other formulas also. Firstly, let us make other formulas. Omega cross v, okay, these are two types of velocities, linear and angular. Now let us make it in terms of single velocity. Jaise hum v ko replace karna chahte hain, to v ke liye formula kya hai? Omega r. This we have done in relation number 2. So v equal to omega r, let us put it here. So it is finally omega square r. Ek formula ye bana centripetal ka. Okay, ab hum ye bhi to kar sakte the ki hum v ki hatane ki jagah omega ko hataye. Agar omega ko hatana ho to kya likhna padega? V by r. So is omega ki jagah v by r. और ये v as it is, तो कितना हुआ v square by r. This is that formula which we generally use in the centripetal force also. mv square by r, no, we use. So you have to remember three formulas of centripetal acceleration. One is this, and one is this. These three formulas. And now you can recall the direction again. You must be remembering that omega was upward, v was tangent. So by right hand thumb rule, omega cross v direction came towards the center. So this is that acceleration which is centripetal acceleration. Okay, तो कैसे याद रखना है? किसी भी circular motion के लिए acceleration के दो parts होंगे. These two parts will be there. So I have written it general formula. Okay, but अगर वो motion uniform circular motion है, तो ये cancel हो जाएगा, सिर्फ ये बचेगा. You can see. ओके और उस एक्सेलरेशन को हम बोलेंगे क्या? सेंट्रीपिटल एक्सेलरेशन. ओके, नाउ सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स एंड सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स, टू फोर्सेस वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स, सो फॉर्मूला हाउ इट विल बी मेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ सेंट्रीपिटल एक्सेलरेशन. सो एफ इक्वल टू एम ए, ए वैल्यू वी विल पुट विच वी डिराइव्ड इन द लास्ट शीट, वी स्क्वायर बाय आर. So mv square by r is the formula of centripetal force, and direction of centripetal force is towards the center. This we have discussed. So what, how can we define it? So the force required by the object to make a circle or to move along a circle is called a centripetal force. Now I will give you two examples. Centripetal force is always provided by any other force present in that situation towards the center. Okay, how it is, let us see. Suppose we take this example. Earth is making a circle around the sun. Okay, when earth is making a circle around the sun, if alone sun is there, hai na? So earth is making the circle. So earth requires the centripetal force. So by what situation the or by what force the centripetal force will be provided? So earth is attracted towards the sun by which force? Gravitational force. So this gravitational force, which is towards the center, that is only playing the role of centripetal force. Okay, so here gravitational force plays the role of centripetal force. Now come this side. This is the example of a bus taking a circular turn. Suppose one bus is coming and it is moving along a circle. So to move along a circle, bus will also require centripetal force. So who will provide it? Okay, so here the friction force between the tires of the bus and the road, that is this side towards the center of the road. This is the center position, okay, because curl is like this. So the in case of the bus taking the turn, friction force becomes the centripetal force, or friction force provides the necessary centripetal force. Okay, so there is the limit in the velocity, so that all we are going to discuss in our coming sheets. So here the idea is, because as soon as the bus will try to take the turn, so what happens, the tires of the bus try to leave the road away from the center. It happens. So because the motion is away from the center, so force is opposite to the motion of the tires. So force is towards the center, force of friction is towards the center. तो इसमें फ्रिक्शन टूवर्ड्स द सेंटर है, इसलिए यही सेंट्रिपिटल फोर्स का रोल प्ले करेगा. ठीक है, सो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग दिस इन डिटेल इन आर डेरिवेशंस. नोट डाउन. नाउ वी हैव द सेकेंड कैटेगरी ऑफ फोर्स, दैट इज सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स, ओके. नाउ लेट अस जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड इट्स मीनिंग. व्हेन एनी बस इज टेकिंग अ शार्प सर्क्यूलर टर्न, okay, a bus is taking a sharp circular turn, what happens, the passengers which are sitting inside the bus, they get a push away from the center. It happens, no? You must have also experienced. So this centrifugal force is that push, okay, away from the center. So what happens when a bus is taking a sharp circular turn? Okay, a sharp circular turn, so center is here, but passengers try to get a push, or they just turn away from the center. Okay, so away from the center, the push which is experienced by the passengers, that is called centrifugal force. Now centrifugal force existence is always related with the centripetal force or with the circle. Okay, that's why we can also call it pseudo force or imaginary force. So what is the overall idea? Let us read one by one. The idea comes from this passenger's case, okay. The passenger sitting in a moving bus experience a push away from the center when the bus takes the turn. This push, because push is also a force only, no? So this push is called the centrifugal force. And why we are calling it a pseudo force or imaginary force? Because its existence is only related with the centripetal. Agar circle hoga, सर्कल में मोशन होगा, तो सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स होगा टूवर्ड्स द सेंटर. तो इसके जस्ट अपोजिट सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स होगा. सो जब बस टर्न लेगी, तो बस को टर्न लेने के लिए चाहिए सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स, और बस के अंदर जो पैसेंजर्स हैं वो मूविंग बस में हैं, इसलिए उनको एक पुश अवे मिलेगा, वो होगा सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. सो बस को चाहिए सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स टूवर्ड्स द सेंटर, ताकि सेंटर से कनेक्टेड रहे, और पैसेंजर्स को एक पुश मिलेगा अवे फ्रॉम द सेंटर, वो होगा सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. सो दिस इज अ स्यूडो फोर्स, ओके. सो इट इज ऑल्सो इट इज एक्सपीरियंस्ड बाय अ पर्सन इन द मूविंग फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरेंस, लाइक अ मूविंग बस, ओके. एंड वॉट इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स? इट्स डायरेक्शन इज अवे फ्रॉम द सेंटर. एंड वॉट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स? इट इज इक्वल टू सेंट्रीपिटल ओनली, so mv square by r, okay. So this is all about the centrifugal, centripetal forces and acceleration idea.